students, welcome back to MJC Learning. In this video, we are going to continue our chapter Transition and Inner Transition Elements of Chemistry. This is part 5 of this chapter. So let's begin. So we are discussing about the trends in atomic properties of transition elements, also known as d-block elements. Till now, we have discussed about the following properties, that is atomic and ionic radii, in which we learn that from left to right, atomic and ionic size decreases in any transition series. Next was ionization enthalpy, in which we concluded that from left to right, ionization enthalpy increases in any transition series. Next was metallic character. All the transition metal shows metallic properties. Next was magnetic properties, in which we learn that nearly all the transition metals, ions and their compounds are paramagnetic, that is they are attracted by magnetic field. Now let's see one more properties, that is color. Formation of colored ions. When a substance absorbs light of a particular wavelength in visible range or visible region, then that substance shows a particular color. Means a substance appears colored if it is absorbed a portion of visible light from 400 to 800 nanometer. Color depends upon the wavelength of absorption in the visible region of electromagnetic radiation. Most of the compound of transition metals are colored in their solid or solution form. Means compound formed by the transition metals are colored. We know that there is an unpaired electron present in d orbital of transition elements. When transition elements are not bonded to anything else, then their d orbitals are degenerate, means when the atoms are free or isolated, the d orbitals are degenerate, means they all are have same energy. And when they start bonding with other ligands due to different in symmetries of the d orbital and inductive effect of the ligand on the electron, the d orbital splits apart and become non-degenerate. Means when the metal ions is complexed with other ions or molecule, some of the d orbital splits apart and become non-degenerate, means higher in energy than the other, means they have different energy level. So here in this diagram, we can see that the d orbital have 5 subshell which splits into 2 groups. These are the 2 groups. So one group consists of the 3 orbital, which is dxy, dxz and dyz, and they are in lower energy level. The second group which is formed is dx square, y square and dz square. These are slightly higher in energy level. So when an electron jumps from lower energy d orbital to higher energy d orbital, that is called d-d transition. The transition metals have incompletely filled d orbital. So energy required to transfer one or more electrons from lower energy to higher energy level within a d orbital with the same principal quantum number is very, very small. Means the difference in energy between the lower energy d orbital and higher energy d orbital, which is generated by the splitting, is very, very small. Means this energy between these two is very small. That is delta E is very small and energy for this transition or transfer is available within a visible range. Therefore, transition metal ions absorb certain radiation from visible region and appear colored. In short, we can say that when an electron from lower energy d orbital is excited to a higher energy d orbital, the energy of excitation corresponds to the frequency of light absorbed. This frequency generally lies in the visible region. The frequency of light absorbed is determined by the nature of the ligand. The color observed corresponds to the complementary color of the light absorbed. So, in this chart, we can see the complementary colors. The complementary color can be easily identified with this diagram. Here we can see that the complementary color are placed diagonally opposite to each other. Means when the red color is absorbed, then transmitted complementary color is green. For example, if the electrons in an octahedral metal complex can absorb green light and get promoted to one lower orbital, means dyz, to higher orbital dz square orbital, the compound will reflect all the color except green. Hence, the complementary color of green will be observed as the color of the compound, which is red. In this table, different colors of 3D transition metal ions are given. Here we can see the ions are given, their outer electronic configuration, number of unpaired electron, and finally color of these ions. So for scandium 3+, electronic configuration is 3d0, means unpaired electron is 0, it is colorless. For titanium 3+, electronic configuration is 3d1. Unpaired electron is 1 and it is purple in color. Here we can see the magnesium 2+, its electronic configuration is 3d5. So unpaired electron is 5 and it is light pink in color. Copper plus 3d10, unpaired electron is 0, it is colorless. And zinc 2+, electronic configuration is 3d10, unpaired electron is 0 and it is colorless. So from this chart we can say that ions which don't have unpaired electron, means for example scandium, titanium 4+, copper plus and zinc 2+, are colorless. Why? Because they don't have unpaired electron. And ions are colored which have unpaired electron in d orbital. So all the ions which have unpaired electron are colored. So we can say that the ions having unpaired electron have certain color and the ion having no unpaired electron are colorless. Colors of the transition metal ions depend upon ligand and geometry of the complex formed by the metal ion. Let's see how can a color depend on ligand and geometry of the complex. Here we can see that there is a two solution given. One is pink in color and second is deep blue in color. So when we dissolve cobalt chloride COCl2, which is CO2+, is dissolved in water, it forms pink color complex, which is COH2O6 2+. This has octahedral geometry. This complex has octahedral geometry. And when this solution is treated with concentrated HCl, hydrochloric acid, it turns deep blue. Why? Because it forms another complex COCl4 2-, which has tetrahedral structure. Here we can see that when the solution is dissolved in water, then it is form octahedral geometry complex, and when this solution is treated with concentrated HCl, it forms tetrahedral complex. So this is the reaction when the first complex is treated with HCl, means when we added chlorine, it will forms COCl4 2- complex plus 6H2O. So here we can say that geometry and nature of ligand are responsible for color of the transition metal ion. We can differentiate same cobalt chloride when dissolved in water, it will give pink color because of octahedral geometry complex, and when this solution is treated with HCl, it turns deep blue by forming another complex which is tetrahedral structure. So we conclude that the color of the transition metal ion related to the following factors. First is presence of unpaired d electrons. When there is a presence of d electron, then the transition metal ion are colored, and when no unpaired electron is present, then they are colorless. DD transition, when the electron jump from one or lower orbital to higher orbital. Nature of ligand attached to metal ion, means nature of ligand which is attached to the metal ion is responsible for the color of transition metal ion. Then geometry of the complex formed by the metal ion. What geometry is formed when the complex is formed is also responsible for the color of transition metal ion. One more factor is also responsible for the color of transition metal ion, that is charge transfer. So color of transition metal ion due to charge transfer. For example, we can say that MnO4- ion has an intense purple color in the solution. This color arises due to the charge transfer. In MnO4- there is a temporary change in the oxidation state of oxygen from O2+ to O-, means 2- to 1-, and reducing the oxidation state of manganese from +7 to +6. Hence there is a charge transfer take place. For charge transfer to take place, the energy level of the two different atoms involved should be fairly close, means the energy between the two atoms which are involved in the charge transfer should be very close or very small. Using this charge transfer, the color of Cr2O7 2-, CrO4-, Cu2O and NiDMG complexes can be explained. Means these complexes are colored due to charge transfer. Thank you.